The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Welcome to In Litchfield. I'm your host, John Latsha. We're coming to you from Studio One here on Charles Bancroft Highway in Litchfield, New Hampshire. Once again, thank you so much for joining me. I really appreciate it. Hey, I would like to thank Ray Peoples. He was a guest on my last show. Ray is running as a write-in candidate for state representative. All right. I wish Ray the best of luck, along with all the other candidates who have the guts. All right, who have the guts to get into public service? Who'd want to do that? I don't know. You got a lot of people that have a lot of guts, I'll tell you that. Hey, on my last show, I was talking to you about my daughter. You know, she just recently bought a home, and she took, you know, a lot of her stuff out of her room now, you know, and I was talking to you about, you know, how emotional I was getting about this, all right? And now most of her things are out of her room now. And, you know, I still get, you know, emotional when I go into her room, you know. The room's fairly empty now, you know. A couple things on the walls and stuff. And, you know, I think back to when, you know, when she was a kid, you know, and, you know, I'd go in there to make sure she was all right, you know, when she was sleeping or when she was sick, you know. I'd go in there, check up on her and stuff. And, you know, to see her accomplishments on the wall, you know, from St. Anselm's College and Brandeis University. And, you know, I was very, very proud of my daughter for what she's accomplished. I hope she's listening, okay? Because she doesn't even watch my show, all right? But maybe this one she might, okay? Because I'm talking about her, of course, right? So anyways, you know, but I have this problem. All right, I have this problem where I'm like, it's supper time and everything, and I'm saying, Kelsey, it's time to eat. Kelsey, it's time to eat. You know, I still think she's upstairs in her room, you know? And my wife goes, John, shut up, all right? Shut up, all right? She's not here anymore, John. Accept the fact, all right? But she didn't call me a wimp, all right? And as you saw my show last show, she called me one of the biggest wimps in Litchfield, all right? One of the biggest wimps. My own wife called me that, all right? And I think, Oscar, what did you... I think, Oscar, you used the word despicable, didn't you? Yeah. See? Despicable, all right? So... So I'm beginning to eat now, okay? I'm making progress, okay? I'm feeling a little bit better now, but, you know, I shed a few less tears now, all right? But I think I'm going to be okay, all right? Like they say, time heals old wounds. All right, hey, public service announcement. Which I usually have from time to time, okay? I don't want to bore you again, all right? Don't turn the station again, all right? Like many of you do when I start talking about public service announcements, all right? But this one's very important. It's the NRPC Hazardous Waste Collection in Nashua. They have two remaining dates available. One is Saturday, October 8th from 8 to 12. And the other one is Saturday, November 5th from 8 to 12. All right, let's take a look at a video of the collection site, courtesy of Merrimack Community Television.
Taking out the trash is a routine task that we barely even think about. But there are some things you just can't throw away. Not for emotional reasons, though. It's potentially hazardous to you and the environment.
If you pick up a bottle, a package, or a container, and you see any sign on there that indicates that it's poisonous, you know, your kind of skull and crossbones, it is flammable or explosive, that's hazardous waste. It can be household cleaners, it can be, you know, insecticides, you know, automotive products, really a wide variety of things that we tend to have in our kitchens, under the counter, in the garage, in the basement, stored away somewhere.
While household hazardous waste can't be tossed with the rest of your trash, there are certain days where it can be taken off your hands. The Nashua Regional Planning Commission helped organize these collections to get that waste out of your house and properly disposed of. You can find a list of hazardous waste on their website, nashuarpc.org. It's only $15 for up to 10 gallons or 20 pounds of household hazardous waste. If you have more than 10 gallons, it's just one additional dollar per gallon. And the drop-off is quick and painless.
People just come up, we check to see how much they have, if it's more or less than 10 gallons, and then just take their money and they just zip around. It's very quick.
All right, a great video from Merrimack Community Television. Hey, the location, I don't think I mentioned that, is on 25 Crown Street in Nashua. Once again, the dates, Saturday, October 8th, 8 to 12, Saturday, November 5th, 8 to 12, and the location is on 25 Crown Street in Nashua. Okay, very good. Hey, some concerning news. Two batches of mosquitoes have tested positive for West Nile virus in Manchester, New Hampshire, okay? And as a former member of the Litchfield Mosquito Control District, okay, I ask all of you to please remove any standing water, if you can, okay, in your yard. All right, and especially after all the rain that we just got, all right, you know, just a little small amount of water, okay, can breed hundreds of mosquitoes. So make sure that you drain off all that water out in your backyard and around your home. All right, keeping everybody safe. Hey, I saw this in the on the news, is that Iran, all right, this stock of uranium enriched to 60%, which is close to weapon grade, okay? And it has grown to be enough for possibly a nuclear bomb, all right? Very, very scary to have Iran, okay, with their hands on a nuclear bomb. I don't think it will ever happen, but who's to say, you know? I mean, wow, very scary stuff going on in the world. All right. Hey, for all you wine drinkers out there, there's a new state liquor and wine store, okay, in Manchester, New Hampshire. It's on Gold Street in Manchester, New Hampshire. So check that out. Brand new state liquor store, liquor and wine store. All right. Hey, September is National Cholesterol Education Month. All right. We all have to watch our cholesterol, all right? Can I have a number one, all right? A number one, a Big Mac, a large fry, and a Coke from McDonald's? Huh? Can we have that? All right. That's what I do. I go to McDonald's too much, all right? My cholesterol level, I mean, when I get home, I get into the chips, all right? As soon as I get home, I get into the chips. I get into the Cheez-Its, all right? Did you ever have, like, maybe a couple of Cheez-Its at once? Okay, you just cannot stop, all right? It grows on you. You have to, like, continuously eat these Cheez-Its, all right? I go probably through a box a week of Cheez-Its, all right? And I mean, how much salt and stuff is that? Cholesterol, all right? And potato sticks, all right? I eat a lot of potato sticks as well. I mean, God, I mean, my cholesterol must be like way sky high. Hey, I was just thinking, like I do from time to time, okay? I think, all right? And there is no town administrator in this town anymore. There is no police chief in this town anymore right now, all right? And everything seems to be going pretty well, all right, that I've seen, all right? I mean, who knows what's going on behind the scenes over here, okay? Poor Karen White over there, I mean, she must be in hiding. I mean, I only see her at the Board of Selectmen meetings from time to time. I mean, the poor woman's got to be ripping her hair out right now, all right? Because she's, you know, trying to do, you know, fill in the void for the town administrator over there, all right? So she's got a lot of work to do, and she does a wonderful job. So Karen, if you're watching on Litchfield Community Television, Channel 20, or on YouTube, you're doing an excellent job. Keep up the great work. All right. Congratulations to the Campbell High School football team on their first win in the home opener. All right. Against Epping New Market. All right. 38-8. A commanding victory. All right. If you'd like to watch the game, you can go to the YouTube channel on Litchfield Community Television. All right. Very good. Hey, we're going to take a commercial break, and we'll be back right after this, so stay with us.
Veterans, when you're struggling, soon becomes later, becomes someday, becomes when. Don't wait. Reach out.
Find resources at va.gov/reach.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to In Litchfield. I'm your host, John Latsha. Hey, Tom Brady and Giselle had a little spat recently, all right? See, she gets mad, all right? She gets mad and she decides to go to Costa Rica, all right? Costa Rica, all right? Why can't you just walk around the block? I mean, wouldn't that be a little, you know, walk around the block a few times, all right? Get all your anger out, okay? And then go back into the mansion again, okay? It's a gated community, all right? That's all she has to do, all right? And here she is, okay, Giselle? I think after Tom Brady won the Super Bowl, right? She's over here pointing in his face over there saying, Tom, this is your last NFL game, or else, all right? Or else, all right? Oh, boy. Do they say money brings love? I don't, you know, I have my doubts between Giselle and Tom over here. Huh? What do you think, huh? Doesn't matter how much money you have, you know. Oh, boy. Hey, I watched the tennis match with Serena Williams, all right? Her last match, all right? And, you know, me and my wife were sitting on the couch, you know, and you know, when I was watching the match go on and on, I was like, and I was on the edge of my seat over here, right? Edge of my seat. And you know, I was watching them, and then, you know, I turned to my wife, and I was going to ask her a question about, you know, Serena and everything, and she was sound asleep, this woman, all right? She was sound asleep. Here I was on the edge of my seat, okay? I mean, I even had to go to the bathroom, and I decided not to because I was like laser focused on this tennis match, all right? And then I, you know, like I said, I look and my wife's like, you know, she's like, oh, cold, all right? Oh, cold, all right? Absolutely no interest in this match whatsoever, all right? Do you see what I go through? Do you see what I go through? Oh, boy, I'll tell you. Wow. But Serena, she had a wonderful career. She really did. Won lots of money. I think she's worth like $250 million. All right? And, you know, she's had a good run in the tennis circuit, definitely. So congratulations to Serena on her supposed retirement. You know, these people keep coming back sometimes, all right? Like Brady, you know, Gronk. I mean, goes on and on and on over here. All right, they can't say no. All right. Hey, Bernard Shaw, I heard on the news, passed away on September 7th. Bernard Shaw was 82 years old. I used to love Bernard Shaw. He was one of those kind of grit anchormen, okay? And when he did an interview with somebody, boy, they knew who they were dealing with, all right? It was fear, okay? Total fear of this guy, all right? And, you know, and we all remember what Bernard Shaw was remembered for, all right? It was when he asked that question in 1988 for the presidential debate, okay? Mike Dukakis, okay? You all remember that, okay? Thank God, all right? Thank God that Bernard asked this question of Dukakis, okay? I couldn't even imagine a President Dukakis. I just couldn't fathom it, all right? Take a look.
Governor, if Kitty Dukakis were raped and murdered, would you favor an irrevocable death penalty for the killer?
No, I don't, Bernard, and I think you know that I've opposed the death penalty during all of my life. I don't see any evidence that it's a deterrent, and I think there are better and more effective ways to deal with violent crime.
So that one question was all it took, all right? It was that knockout punch by Bernard Shaw, okay? He knocked out Mike Dukakis, okay? And he never got up, all right? That was it, all right? But Dukakis, okay? I mean, who's running this guy's campaign? I don't understand. I mean, he did another dumb thing, all right? Remember when he got into the tank? Okay, this guy's running for president. He's in a tank, this guy? I mean, can you believe it? I mean, I just don't understand. These people that are around these people are supposed to be smart people, all right? But obviously, somebody gave him some bad advice, all right? Somebody gave him some bad advice. All right. Hey, I've been doing Litchfield Community Television for a little over 7 years now, all right? And I enjoy doing it. I really do. I really enjoy doing it. But I would really like to see more people come to Litchfield Community Television, okay? We want you, okay? We want you, okay, to show, I mean, we, this whole town here, okay, we must have people that can play a musical instrument on Litchfield Community Television, right? We must have somebody that has a great voice, okay, that can sing karaoke on Litchfield Community Television. And you could even have your own show like me, all right? I got my name up in lights over here, okay? See that? All right, up in lights, all right? And so can you. All right, we have a beautiful studio here. Nice green screen. We have up-to-date cameras and computers, software. All right, I guess that's the right terminology for it, okay? My name's not John Bernal, all right? John, you're in another show. But we have a lot, one of the best things that we have here is we have very talented people. Very talented people that will help you, okay? Well, that will help you be successful at whatever you do on Litchfield Community Television. I was just mentioning that we have some football games, high school football games on Litchfield Community Television. We usually have some basketball games on Litchfield Community Television. We have Ralph Bohm. He's State Representative Ralph Bohm doing shows on Litchfield Community Television. And I don't think that people actually know that this facility actually exists. All right? But it does. It's a great facility. It really is. And you should come down and give it a try, okay? All you have to do is go to lctv@comcast.net. That's lctv@comcast.net. And they will guide you in the right direction. All right? So it's a great venue here. As I said, I really enjoy it. And I hope you do as well. So thank you very much. All right, Oscar, do you have anything that you would like to add to our show today? Nothing at all. Oscar's quiet. Oscar wants to go home. No, I'm just kidding. Oscar would stay here. Oscar would sleep over here, okay, if he had to, all right? He has that fire. Look at him. He's over there. I wish he had a camera on right now. Look at him smiling over there. He's ready to fall out of his chair over there, okay? But he has that fire in his stomach, all right? That, all that, oh boy, I'm talking really good about you right now, Oscar, right? He has that energy, all right? He loves community television, as I do, as well. And it shows. He does an excellent job, along with Russ, Rob, and everybody else that's connected to Litchfield Community Television. I mean, even if you'd like to go, you know, hold a camera or something at one of these sporting events, all right, to learn how to hold a camera and operate a camera, you can do that as well, too. You don't have to come on the show or whatever. Just you can do that as well if you'd like to volunteer. That's another great thing. All right, we're coming down to the end of our show. On my next show, I would like everybody to know that we're going to have a representative from either an auto mechanic or an auto repair owner, okay? We're going to be talking about auto repair and maintenance on your cars, okay? What to look out for, what not to look out for, what to do, what not to do. Should be an interesting show. Until then, I'll see you next time. I'm your host, John Latsha, and that's in Litchfield. We'll see you next time, everybody. Bye-bye. Take care. Bye.
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.